From CivilNet through the World Wide Web, this is our daily Armenia News Digest for Thursday, October 10th. I'm Maria Titizian.
And I'm Paul Chadurjian. In today's digest, a top cop found guilty of embezzling $400,000 is set free.
Plus, a tense standoff between police and protesters at the grand reopening of the Pagshuga.
And we take you to where Armenia Fund plans to build a new highway between Armenia and Artsakh.
Later, how $2 million is about to help empower women in business. We begin today with three high-profile criminal cases.
Former traffic police chief Markar Ohanian is a free man today. He was released from prison as part of the general amnesty proposed by Armenia's president and approved by the National Assembly last week. Ohanian was charged and then found guilty of abuse of position and large-scale embezzlement of property. According to documents, the former police chief misappropriated 574,420 liters of gasoline, which was to be used by traffic cops. The estimated value of the fuel was 160 million dirhams, or about $420,000. In a second case, bail was denied once again for ANC activist Ikran Arakelian.
He's been behind bars for over 2 years now, accused of hooliganism and attacking a police officer. Emotions were running high in the courtroom after the judge yet again denied Arakelian the possibility of bail. The young man, who many hope will be released as part of President Sarkisian's amnesty, announced to the court and all present that he will refuse the proposed amnesty. Yesterday, we told you about an unexpected turn of events at the hearing into the beating murder of army doctor Vahe Avedian.
Five men who were accused of beating him to death have now changed their testimonies. One of the accused, Norar Hayrabedian, said that although his intention was not to kill the doctor, he is to blame for beating Avedian. Two other defendants also changed their testimonies and took blame for beating two other men who were with Avedian at the time of the scuffle. Avedian's lawyers, Dikran Yergoyan and Lusine Agopian, told reporters that they believe the defendants changed their testimonies so that they will be tried for the lesser offense of assault and battery, and also so that they too will be able to be released under the president's proposed amnesty.
Lawyers and Armenia's Minister of Justice, Hrar Tomasyan, are at odds over a bill that would require lawyers to pay an annual registration fee. The 60,000 dirham fee equals about $145. It would be used to finance the public defender's office. Chairman of the Chamber of Advocates of Armenia, Ara Zorabian, in a message to Minister Tovmasyan, requested the removal of the draft amendments. In the letter, he states, "Why should those fees be directed towards sustaining the public defender's office? Why should the lawyer pay for a function that is the responsibility of the state?" End of quote. Lawyers say that the amount is not the issue. What is the issue is that the Ministry of Justice is strapped for cash and it's using lawyers to fulfill its public commitments.
The landmark enclosed farmers market on Mashtots marked its grand reopening today after it was shut down for renovations. In its new incarnation, the Pagshuga is home to a modern supermarket with stalls set aside for some of its previous farmer tenants. The landmark building is owned by government-linked tycoon Samuel Alsanian. On the occasion of the market's grand opening, activists and concerned citizens gathered nearby at Mashtots Park and then walked to the Shuga to protest what they consider to be a distortion of the historical building. According to CivilNet reporter Datev Ghazarian, who was on the scene, the activists were confronted with a heavy police presence and hundreds of Alsanian supporters. The police did not allow the activists near the building, and supporters of the businessman were chanting for the activists to leave. You can watch the full report on civilnet.am.
The residency requirements for presidential candidacy could soon change. The president's office has submitted a request to the special commission set up to look at possible constitutional reforms. The request calls for the reduction in the 10-year residency restrictions in the current constitution. Article 50 says, quote, "Every person having attained the age of 35, having been a citizen of the Republic of Armenia for the preceding 10 years, having permanently resided in the Republic for the preceding 10 years, and having the right to vote, is eligible to be elected President of the Republic." Viken Sarkisian, head of the President's staff, confirmed that he personally submitted the reforms package to the Commission. Many believe the proposal to reduce the 10-year residency restriction is connected to Armen Sarkisian, who was recently appointed Armenia's ambassador to the United Kingdom and who has not been a permanent resident of Armenia for a number of years. This is seen to be giving Sarkisian a chance for a shot at the presidency.
Today on CivilNet, Tatul Hagopian reported about the new 114-kilometer or 17-mile highway that will be built by the Hayastan All-Armenian Fund, creating a second link between Armenia and Artsakh. The Vartanis to Mardagert highway will pass through Karvajar and will be funded by this year's annual telethon, which takes place on Thursday, November 28th, which is Thanksgiving Day in the U.S. Karvajar has been one of the most contentious issues in the peace process. Tatul reports that the more Armenians populate the Karvajar area, the more difficult it'll be for the area to be handed back to the Azeris. You can watch Tatul's entire report on CivilNet.
Companies in Armenia that are owned or partially owned by women will receive assistance from the government of Armenia to the tune of $2 million. The funding will be used to provide loan guarantees. This issue will be discussed today at the cabinet meeting of the government. The amount will be allocated by the Small and Medium Entrepreneurship Development National Center of Armenia. According to an agreement with the Asian Development Bank, the center will be obligated to provide financial support to Armenia's 300 small and medium-sized businesses that are owned and managed by women entrepreneurs. Yesterday, Azerbaijanis went to the polls to elect their country's next president.
And as expected, incumbent Ilham Aliyev easily won his third term to the country's highest office. A day earlier, media in the country were scrambling to report about a major phone app failure, which announced the results of the election a day before they actually happened. The Central Election Commission of Azerbaijan introduced an iOS and Android app specifically for the elections. Users who downloaded the app a day before the elections were shocked to see predetermined results on their phones. And not only, they were even provided information about the number of people who voted and how many voters voted the various times during the day. According to media sources, the CEC apparently forgot to activate this section currently closed button. Opposition leaders say this was the dirtiest election in Azerbaijani history. As we reported yesterday, Gyumri has been selected as the cultural capital of the CIS for 2013.
That's right. We just learned that within the framework of the celebrations this weekend, a festival of bread. Many festivals this year in Armenia. This year we have a festival of bread in Gyumri, and it will be held by the Shirak Armenian Studies Research Center. So if you're in Gyumri and want to participate, it will be held on Sunday, October 13th at 1 p.m. Armenia time at the Museum of National Architecture and Urban Life. And the address, for all those interested, is 47 Hakhtanag Avenue.
I think the entire staff at CivilNet is going to be on Hakhtanag Avenue that
Probably.
Day. The dollar today buys you 406 Armenian dirhams.
The other exchange rates for the day have the British pound worth 649 dirhams, the euro gets you 549 dirhams, and the ruble buys you 12.5 dirhams. And what's the weather going to be like in the next couple of days?
The forecast calls for Yerevan to have a high of 21 today. That's in Celsius, and that's 70 degrees Fahrenheit, which Murray doesn't like because Canadians follow the metric system.
Like half the world does, actually.
The temperatures will be around 70 degrees or 20 Celsius for the rest of the week. Overnights will stay around lows of 40s, which is 6 to 7 degrees Celsius.
So make sure that you have your blanket out like you do every night for the past week. And that's our digest for this Thursday, October the 10th.
We want to hear from you. Our email address once again is english@civilnet.am.
See you tomorrow.